Hello and welcome. Today I want to show you some crazy news about the Quest Pro, a new Guardian intrusion detection version called Space Sense, which was updated in both v32 and v33, and other news about the updates. With the Facebook Connect 2021 event coming up in about a month, there's definitely a lot to talk about. So let's talk about the hardware. The Quest Pro, aka Seacliff, aka Arcata, will have some great improvements over the previous Oculus Quest. The cameras changed, so instead of 4 monochrome OV7251 cameras, we now have 7 cameras on the Quest Pro. 2 of the same monochrome OV7251 cameras, for upper face and eye tracking, 2 monochrome OV6211 cameras for lower face tracking, which seem to be connected to some kind of FPGA for data compression, 2 outward directed OG01A1B near infrared cameras, probably for some kind of depth mapping, and last but not least, a Sony IMX471 120fps 4K color sensor for beautiful color pass-through. I guess the dreams of the Reddit user Samulia were surprisingly lucid. Then there are new Starlight controllers, which don't have a tracking ring like the Quest 2 Jedi controllers, and probably feature rechargeable controllers that you can charge with a dock instead of having to replace the batteries. The coolest thing about them is that there are 3 OV7251 cameras positioned on the top, on the front like shown in this leak, and another camera somewhere else. I think the controllers themselves do some kind of constellation tracking that tracks the Quest Pro from the Starlight controllers, which by the way run a version of Android, and will send the tracking data to the Quest Pro via a 2.4 or 5 GHz Wi-Fi connection that is established between them. Maybe that's why they are called Starlight, as constellations are typically made up of stars. Who knows? The headset tracking itself is going to be accomplished with 2 near-infrared cameras and an IR light projector called Nautilus, which enables the Quest Pro to get accurate depth information from the environment. That is roughly comparable to how the Face ID works on the iPhone. Additionally, the Quest Pro also seems to get a new cooling solution. Not quite as overkill as the water cooling setup Thrill Seeker made for their Quest 2, but I think a second fan on the Oculus Quest Pro should be enough. The new display model seems to be a dual panel or some kind of dual video display with local dimming zones that will enable much better black levels. There are also multiple calibration routines for eye and face tracking, which were added in V30. To set up face tracking, you'll need to copy a set of 5 expressions: a neutral expression, a smile, a frown, an angry expression, and a surprised expression. For eye tracking, you will just need to follow a target with your eyes to calibrate the tracking. You might have already seen my tweet about how Guardian intrusion detection is now called Space Sense in V32. But that's not all. I will first show you the V32 video demo, and then the V33 video with full color. You first see someone playing Beat Saber, until a kid playing on its mobile phone enters the Guardian, with a ghostly purple look. Then it switches to a new sequence with someone else playing another game, and a small child entering the Guardian while spinning. If you look closely at the upper left corner, we can see some of the project information which tells us that Oculus is using Autodesk Maya for these videos. In V33, the video got updated and now looks a lot more complete and polished. The initial Beat Saber sequence got scrapped, and I honestly can't see why. We will also get something called Room Capture, which will enable us to have a virtual representation of our environment in VR, and that's probably going to use the depth sensor capabilities of the Quest Pro. So all the Quest versions are probably out of luck, maybe with some little bit of trickery, but who knows. Additionally, there's a new mention of the Mixed Reality Pass-Through API, which isn't yet available without ADB commands. A new feature called VRS Rewind, which is able to export the last 15 seconds of gameplay and sensor data after a crash or for a bug report to Facebook, is also being worked on. This is what the internal tool Facebook uses to look at the recordings looks like. I'll probably keep this disabled if it gets added, but if you want to get spied on and help Facebook improve their tracking, this is probably the best way to achieve that. There's also now a stereoscopic boot logo consisting out of 2 files, one for each panel, and I. It definitely looks way more interesting than the old one. We will also get a settings option, which will let us only use 3DoF tracking for seated gameplay, and a new indicator for when our play space is too dark. Enjoy these two frames of animation I've found. There's also a new hidden virtual desktop pullout experiment. I'm not sure what it will do, but it might be related to an upcoming remote desktop feature I found, similar to what we've already have in workrooms right now. Of course, VRLauncher has been updated to both v32 and v33. You can now get it on my GitHub. But these two versions mostly removed features. In the end, I want to thank Xeros for sponsoring me a new Quest 2. Very cool. And as always, thanks for watching this video. Support me on Ko-fi and join the Discord with the link in the description. I will see you next time, and in case you have any questions, feel free to ask me in the comment section. Bye!